We are a Detroit-based energy provider of about 2 million customers in Michigan in both gas and electric services. Our Detroit-based headquarters, which is where we are currently located, occupies about 1.3 million square feet and is comprised of about three major buildings. As DTE transforms the way it produces power, we want to lead by example. We're focusing on reducing energy, and this includes steam, electricity, and natural gas, our water and waste, by at least 25% by the year 2022.
We completed energy assessments here at the headquarters, but we also went out and completed them at 40 different locations across the state of Michigan. Early on, we realized that we weren't going to be able to do and work on all of our buildings all at once. So we developed a strategy that focused on our headquarters for DTE Energy. Our headquarters is one of our larger facilities, and it's where we could really make the biggest impact first. And so that became our focus point.
Anything you look at moving forward to become a more green and more energy efficient building starts out with data collection. And it starts out with collaboration. It starts out with collaboration between management, between the data collectors, and the people like myself with the wrenches on the floor.
So we let people know what we were doing, when we were doing them, and also found ways that we could have them participate in our energy efficiency projects.
So the project that I was involved in was we took about, there's four floors that we retrofitted 3,000 fixtures and converted them to LEDs, so which means we took out T8 fluorescents and converted with LEDs. I can tell you, since we've installed them, we haven't had any calls on those floors as far as lights being burned out or, you know, trouble with the fluorescent. We were going back in a lot of maintenance, but as far as the energy use, it'll save the company lots of money.
We put in frequency drives on a water system, our domestic water system. This water delivery system has to be able to deliver a sustained and equal amount of water throughout 24 floors of building, occupied building space. It does that by monitoring the pressure in the pipes, and the freak drives ramp up and down as usage dictates, which is saved over 30% because of the use of the freak drives. The kilowatt hours have been driven down, and we're still able to supply and maintain adequate pressures throughout the building.
We put metering on our primary services so we could have real-time energy use, so we knew exactly how much energy we were using throughout the building. I think we put that on before the project, so once we're done with everything, and I think that we'll be able to take a look at the data and see how much we've saved.
I want to speak a little bit about how we really acquired a full 33% savings on our energy usage in the service building. Some of that included a gymnasium being built on the sixth floor, where we used different energy efficient rooftop units to maintain desired temperatures in that space.
So Battle of the Buildings, the contest this year was a great learning experience for me, as well as a fun way of figuring out ways to engage not only our employees, but our facilities business unit to really go that extra mile and to achieve greatness with our sustainability program.
For me, energy efficiency is a big deal. We're putting our money where our mouth is. We're taking the money and reinvesting it in our infrastructure, doing it wisely, driven by data, to move forward into the next century and be a very lean and energy efficient company.